afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone, and a very warm welcome to the Music for the Moment. The Music for the Moment concert series is led in partnership with Resonate Arts and the Royal Academy of Music. It is a monthly concert series with some concerts taking place here at Wigmore Hall and others at St. Marylebone Parish Church. The next concert will be on Friday, 15th March at St. Marylebone Parish Church and will feature performances from harpists Bonnie Scott and Gina Gallagher. We have some flyers with upcoming dates, so please do take one home with you today. If you would like to hear more about future concerts or other local activities, please speak to Sophie, who is here from Resonate Arts. A few notes for today's concert. Please be aware that today's concert is being live streamed for people to watch at home. The footage will not feature anyone in the audience. A big hello to everyone who is watching the live stream. You're welcome to take photos of our performers today and the people you're attending with, but please do not photograph other audience members, and please make sure the flash is switched off. Please also ensure that your mobile phone is set to silent or turned off. Do feel free to come and go as you need during the concert and move about in the auditorium if you need to. We encourage everyone to be mindful of others' wishes regarding social distancing. We would love to invite you to join us for more refreshments after the concert in the foyer, and I believe the performers will be staying, so you can have a chat with them afterwards. Now, please would you join me in welcoming to the stage Iona, Ariel, Susie, and Jonathan of the Asaka Quartet.
We are the Asaka Quartet. My name's Iona, this is Ariel, Susie and Jonathan, and we're very happy to be here performing for you this afternoon. We're going to start with Haydn's Opus 54, number 2, string quartet, and we're going to play the first two movements of this piece. While we're playing, there will be some images behind us which we've selected to go alongside each of these movements. The first movement is an exciting, sprightly first movement, vivace, and this will go straight into the second movement, which is a chorale, a rather dark chorale, which continues as the movement develops. This continues in the lower strings, and the first violin takes on an almost improvisatory quality over the top. So these two movements will run into each other and will last about 10 minutes. I should say, please feel free to move around at any point. You don't need to wait till a break in the music at all. So this is Haydn's Opus 54, number 2.
Thank you.
Now for something completely different. This is a piece called Shine You No More, and this is an arrangement by the Danish String Quartet. This piece is great fun, so please feel free to tap, clap, stamp along, however you feel fit. We're going to continue with something completely different again. We're now going to play the complete work, Fanny Mendelssohn Hensel's String Quartet in E-flat major. Fanny Mendelssohn was the sister of Felix Mendelssohn, who you may have heard of. She is thought to have composed around 500 works in her lifetime. And a lot of her works were originally published under her brother's name to begin with. Felix Mendelssohn was invited to Buckingham Palace by Queen Victoria, and she specifically asked for a performance of her favorite, which was a piece called Italienne, and Felix had to explain that his sister had actually written that. This is definitely written by her, the string quartet. It's in four movements. I will introduce the first two movements to begin with. It starts with a beautiful slow adagio, and this runs into a scherzo, which is very exciting. So this is the first two movements of Fanny Mendelssohn's quartet.
Thank you.
We're going to continue now with the third and fourth movements of the quartet. This third movement is a beautiful, very lyrical romanza, and then this goes into a tumbling vivace fourth movement.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're doing a little bit of musical chairs now for our next movement. This is Borodin String Quartet No. 2, and this is the third movement. This is probably the most well-known themes out of String Quartet No. 2. It's very, very lyrical and beautiful. It lasts about 10 minutes. I realised I forgot to say that the images that are projected behind us are taken by our very own Ariel, so they've been specially selected.
Thank you.
We have another short piece by the Danish String Quartet. This is Tjønneblomen, which I'm probably pronouncing totally wrong. So please, if anybody knows Norwegian, I would love to know how to pronounce this afterwards with a cup of tea. And this translates as the water lily. We have one last piece to share with you this afternoon. This is the third movement of Arnold Bax's String Quartet No. 1 in G major. We came across this piece a couple of years ago. It's not so well known, but it's one of our absolute favorites now. This last movement is very folky. There's been a bit of a theme today. And in the middle of it, out of nowhere, appears a folk melody, which Bax claims to have wrote. But after some performances in Ireland, the Irish audiences were convinced that this tune already exists, and it's claimed to be a close cousin of the Fair Hills of Ireland.
Thank you.